Welcome to Campus, the magazine show dedicated to university sports. This week we're in Lausanne in Switzerland at the City Events Conference linking cities through sport. Continuing our series meeting university champions who went on to conquer the Olympics and Worlds in their chosen sports, this week we talk to French canoeing legend Tony Estanguet. In early November, Eilat in Israel staged the World University Weightlifting Championships. We were there too for a closer look at this most popular of university sports. And we check out the finals of the recent World University Championships in beach volleyball from where else but Brazil. All that and more can be found on this edition of Campus. Welcome to Lausanne for a convention called City Events, the annual conference that connects cities from around the world through their sporting federations. Through conferences and one-to-one meetings, this event organised by the International University Sports Federation and GL Events is the premier marketplace where cities meet through sport. To organise a sporting event, you need the help of cities or regions which have a sporting infrastructure, so it's important to link everything together, these cities and regions, with sports federations to create an exchange platform for these partners. Projects like Universiades are great investments for cities and, by extension, countries.
Is really, in modern society, is an important part of educational system. If you see America or Asia or Europe, the biggest university has very, very strong sport systems, sport clubs and sport competitions regularly system. And now Russia also trying to construct a new system, sport and education, to coordinate, to integrate two areas.
Krasnoyarsk in central Russia is the first city to apply for the 2019 Winter Universiade. We want the Universiade because we understand that it means not only a sporting event, but a humanitarian event, an opportunity to involve the young in social and political processes linked with the development of the city, a region, our country, Russia, an opportunity for us to feel ourselves as part of the global world, connected. We want to be in it, we want to be in harmony with it, demonstrate our best accomplishments, benefit from the accomplishments that have existed in other countries. The next Universiade will take place in Kazan in Russia in July next year, with 27 sports on the schedule. This will be the biggest World University Sports Championships ever staged. Kazan says it's almost ready, with 85% of infrastructures all set to go. Only two sporting venues are not yet ready.
The 1st of March on 2013, the main stadium on 45,000 spectators will be finished, and on this year, on the end of this year, on the end of December, the Aquatic Palace also will be finished, and that's why we'll be 100% be ready for Universiade.
USA, the Universiade is an important moment. American athletes are excited about coming to Kazan.
There is a great deal of curiosity factor about a city that, frankly, many Americans are not familiar with, but have heard fantastic stories about what a great city it is and what a great sports city in particular it is.
In 2015, the Summer Universiade will take place in Gwangju in Korea. Many projects and programs represent the Gwangju Universiade. With the United Nations Office of Sport and Development, they would like to reach out further to the world beyond sport and encourage the use of sport as a means to promote development and peace. One of the main goals is to achieve peace close to home in the Korean Peninsula.
We have been developing a single team project as a great legacy program.
A single team project as a great legacy United program Nations joined with the United
Koreas,
Nations to create
but also
world
peace. It
there are initiatives
United
that the United Nations
and,
has extended,
movement
on peace and youth sport.
It is first time
it's the first
in
time
history
in history to make a single team between the two Koreas in such a multi-sport event. The General Secretary of the United Nations, Mr. Ban Ki-moon, announced that he fully supports the United single team for the Gwangju Universiade 2015. This week we went to Pau in the southwest of France to meet triple canoe Olympic and former Universiade champion Tony Estanguet. Three times an Olympic champion, three times a world champion, we met Tony at the place he knows best, the Whitewater University Club of Pau Pyrenees, where everything began for him. After studying in Toulouse, Tony went on to two successes in the World Cup in 96 and 97, and he took part in the 1998 World University Championships in Metz, in France.
Ce titre de champion du monde universitaire en 98, c'est mon premier titre international.
Donc c'est un World University Champion title in 1998 was my first international title. So you can really say that it launched my career. It's true that a title is a title, it's a one-day competition, you have to be ready on that day. What was interesting in 98 was that 80% of the world's best athletes were present at the start of those games. It was the start for me towards the preparation for the Sydney Olympics. Besides Tony, the canoe World University Championships had big names on the start list. Other Olympic champions like David Florence, the Horshorner brothers, or Alina Kaliska.
C'est parti un peu des valeurs de ce sport, d'être obligé de combiner un projet d'études en parallèle de sa carrière sportive.
You should combine study parallel to your sporting career.
Et ensuite,
plenty of us have done university
aussi,
studies. In our sport, there aren't many events a year, so we're happy to participate in these university competitions. It's a kind of springboard for a high-level career. The stakes aren't as high as in a world championship or the Olympic Games, but there's a question of excellence and of competition at the best level. It's a good way to cut one's teeth, to really measure and judge your value, to learn and to gather competition experience. With the first World University Canoeing Championships in 1994 in Prague, the winner was already named Estanguet, but this was Patrice, Tony's elder brother, who went on to win the bronze medal at the Atlanta Olympics of 1996.
C'est une histoire de famille une fois de plus dans ce sport. C'est assez marrant parce qu'on a gagné les deux premières éditions donc
This is a family story in this sport. It's fun because we won the first two editions of the World University Championships. Patrice is really an example that I tried to follow. He was the first one in the family. He was the first one to combine sport and study. He was the first to win an Olympic medal at Atlanta. And me, 5 years younger, I followed his example. Tony, indeed, another example of those that have launched their competitive spirit at a
universiade.
I was registered at a university club since the beginning of my career. When I started, there were 30 or 40 of us there. Now there are 250 members. You have to acknowledge the merit of university sport. These structures which are trying to promote values of integration through sport, besides excellence and competition, I think are very important. Tony won the gold medal at Sydney in 2000, Athens 2004, and eventually again at London 2012. This last title in particular, very special for Tony after the surprising failure in 2008.
Ce titre à Londres, c'est vrai qu'il il résonne de manière très forte dans ma carrière parce que
The title in London has a very strong significance for me. It was the outcome of a beautiful story after 4 years of fighting to return to the best level, especially after the failure of Beijing, which really hurt me. I had the idea that I was in a movie-type scenario with suspense until the last scene. Difficult selection, and finally, it came good for me. But after winning every title there is to win in a canoe, Tony is still thinking about his future, but he'll surely never forget where his career began. the road to the Negev Desert, situated on the edge of the Red Sea in the south of the country, Eilat is one of the most popular sea resorts in Israel. And from the 4th to the 10th of November, the third edition of the World University Weightlifting Championships was staged here. There were more than 150 athletes competing from 28 countries, all of them between 17 and 28 years of age. Rigor, seriousness, and discipline in the training session early in the morning here. The first new records were set on the second day of competition. The junior world record set by Wei Deng from the Sports Vocational and Technical College in Fujian Province from China, and the 58 kilogram category with a total of 244 kilograms. Surprised afterwards, she said, I didn't expect it. There's a lot of competition here, she added, but I also get time for some fun. The Chinese delegation heading the women's competition were escorted by Chen Winbin, a popular head coach from Beijing. Weightlifting is one of the most important sports for us. For the last 10 years, weightlifting as a sport in China has been strongly pushed and developed in universities. It's for this reason we help students to combine study and training. The Chinese team achieved the best performance of the competition thanks to Meng Suping, a student at the Sports Coach College, Beijing Sport University, and a silver medalist at the World Championships in 2010. She set a new clean and jerk senior world record in the women's 75 kilogram and over category with 188 kilograms. I want to do better in Kazan. Well, Russian athletes dominated the men's competition. The National History Studies at SS University. Mezhkilov won the 105 kilos and over. The Physical Culture Studies, Volga Region State Academy of Physical Culture, Sport and Tourism, Muratov took the gold medal. Russia with 12 golds, 8 clear of the nearest best, Moldova. Japan chipping in with 3 golds as well. Russia was second to China in the women's table, with Chinese Taipei taking 3 golds as well. University Championships were not only a competition boasting future world stars, but also athletes who simply just have a passion for their sport. Some of them have to deal daily with logistical and organisational problems in comparison to major or better supported nations. Let's speak to an athlete
because
from
most
the US.
Of us work, go to school and train, so it's hard to lift twice a day, like some other countries like China and Russia and all the countries that train twice a day. Normally, your athlete from the U.S. will, like I said, have school, work, and have to train.
Colombia was represented by 3 athletes. Jesus Martinez Castro this year hopes to graduate as a doctor. I'm studying medicine, I do a lot of sport at a high level, it's hard, but I think this gives you confidence and discipline to do both. You get self-confidence, and it's good, I think, for life in general. Olga Zubova was part of the Russian squad at the last Olympic Games in London. Here she won the gold medal in the 75 kilogram category in this World University Weightlifting Championships.
нас проходят иногда по две тренировки в день.
We sometimes have two training sessions a day, and these days we don't study at university because we don't have enough time. University professors understand that, and if we miss classes, we can submit our assignments the next day for the day that we missed. Jacqueline Ferreira from Brazil was a surprise in this competition. She was also part of the Brazil squad in London. Second place here. We're all preparing for next year in Kazan in Russia in order to be part of the squad for the next University Games. We'll be fighting to be on the podium once again with Russia and the other countries. For sure, we'll be stronger and better prepared. Lukasz Grela from Poland won the gold medal in the 94 kilogram snatch category.
Uczenia przede wszystkim pomagają mi się rozwijać naukowo. Podczas wyjazdów muszę mieć
University helps me to develop intellectually when I can't follow my lessons due to competition. I present my schedule to them. I have scholarships from the university for my good sporting results and I follow a personal university program.
Indywidualnym toku studiowania.
In Eilat, we met two icons from the world of weightlifting. The gold medalist in the Munich 72 Olympic, Zygmunt Smalczyk from Poland. The Greek silver medalist from Atlanta 96 and Sydney 2000, Leonidas Sabanis.
I help them to learn the, you know, what I know. No, my experience to give them like that.
Zygmunt Smalczyk. His coach, the USA delegation.
I take care about education, and to be better, to be not only good in weightlifting, just in the life.
The FISU embraced weightlifting and took it up in its World Championship program. We are very happy about this, really, and very proud. And of course, the International Weightlifting Federation remains very dedicated to these World Championships.
The 2012 World University Weightlifting Championships in Eilat was a real success, and all the participants enjoyed being there for the competition and maybe the dancing at the end. But also to celebrate with students from all over the world. Not to mention taking another step on the ladder of preparation for Kazan 2013. Gangnam Style on campus. The ship Sadov that's carrying the lantern of the 2013 Summer Universiade flame is halfway from the shores of Peru to French Polynesia on its round-the-world voyage. The legendary tall ship is heading for Papeete. Within a month, the ship will have covered 4,350 nautical miles. The torch left Paris in July and will end up in Vladivostok in January. Kazan organised another test event in the run-up to the 27th Summer Universiade next year. The Rhythmic Gymnastics Russian Cup and Russian Rhythmic Gymnastics Group Championship were held in mid-November in the Gymnastics Centre. Kazan will also welcome, at the end of November, the Student World Cup in Sambo, a martial arts sport which is part of the Universiade programme for 2013. French company Girflor was awarded by the FISU as the best commercial partner of the year, especially after their contribution to Shenzhen 2011. Great homage for us to have contributed to the success of the Universiade and FISU. Girflor is an international company. We partner with several federations, and it's an honour that FISU awards us an international quality label on the way we approach their events and the way we help them. The 25th Summer Universiade was held in 2009 in Belgrade. Serbia welcomed the Universiade for the first time, and one event in particular was especially popular with the local fans, basketball. All the best teams from around the world were there, especially Team USA, who, after missing the medal podium in 2007, were determined to regain the title they'd won. 2005. Serbia were among the favourites too and had a perfect start in the tournament with successes over Greece, Australia and Finland. Last game of the pool was against the US and both teams offered a tremendous match in front of 14,000 at the Belgrade Arena. The USA edged it by 2 points. They were top in the group. The USA were destined to reach the final, but Russia sprung a surprise in the semi and beat the US 69-68. With a decisive three-pointer from Shabalkin just 24 seconds before the end. So it was Russia and not Team USA who made the final. Who were they up against? Serbia. July 11th, 2009, at home in front of 20,000 crazy spectators. Serbia wouldn't let Russia have any opening. At halftime, Serbia were already up 39-31. And thanks to a great team effort, Serbia won at the end, 73-51, an historic title for Serbia. A fantastic advert for the Universiade. Six World University Beach Volleyball Championships took place in Maceio in Brazil in September and boasted a tremendous tournament under the Brazilian sun. More than 40 teams representing 17 countries from the Americas, Europe and Asia participated in this International University Sports Federation event. In the women's tournament, the Spanish pair of Cristina Hoff and Alejandra Simon from San Antonio Catholic University reached the final. After beating the Germans of Labera and Schumacher in the semis, in the second semi, Summer Ross and Emily Day from the US beat the Czech team of Bonarova and Hermanova. Spain started better in the final, but the USA got back into it. Ross and Daly increased their advantage and won the first set 21-16. The pace was kept up by the US in the second set, but Spain didn't let them get clear. Spain never gave up, returned at 19-all, and the USA won the second set, final victory.
It was so tough. The Spaniards are so good, man. They had us a lot of times, and it was just really great to play them. But Emily played a great game. She, like, saved me. I kept setting her a little tight, and she would poke it over the block. She did a great job.
So the USA will go into the Universiade next summer as the gold medalists of the world. In the women's beach volleyball, the men's final was an all-European duel between Germans Armin Dullinger and Jonas Schroner and Garcia and Marco from Spain. Germany, having beaten Brazil 2-1 in the semis, Spain came through against Canada. Germany came through the first set 21-17. Spain didn't give up though. Good start to the second set. They came back to 20-19 like the women's, but Germany came through and match point. Block out on Schroeder's last smash 21-17, 21-19. It was a gold medal for Germany.
We have some troubles with the heat. We are not used to this, and yeah, I guess Spain is a bit more powerful. I think we played a pretty good match. We stayed cool all the time, and yeah, I'm happy. Yeah.
So Germany, the defending world champions at the Universiade next year. Spain won the silver medal, completing the podium. The local Brazilians. A That's all for now, but next month, episode number 5 of Campus will be in Gwangju in Korea for a special feature on the host city of the 2015 Summer Universiade. We'll be getting to know the city a little better and enjoying the action from the World University Championships in badminton. That's next month on Campus. For now, though, bye-bye.